So best of five, first pair to three.
Great start. And good support as well in the venue.
I'm impressed. I knew that Lin Wenru had a screaming section of women out there in the crowd, but Zheng Yijing has a loyal fan club as well. No question about the other side where the Chinese national team goes. Fans are sure to show up. It's tough with Sun Yingxia waiting there for the forehand.
Well, we talked about this Chinese Taipei player, Lin Wenru, currently sixth in the world. Zheng Yijing, she's 12th, so great players in their own right. Sun Yingxia, of course, world number one. Wang Chuxin is 13th in the world.
1-3.
So great singles players in their own right as well.
Yeah, the one reason I would say that, well, it's tough to say. I was going to say this pair right here is a better chance than you might think.
Current world champions as well, aren't they?
1-4.
Wang and Sun from the Houston World Championships just a few months ago.
So both sides have their experience playing together, and as individuals, well, the Chinese pair the higher ranked. So again, an uphill battle.
Four, two.
I wondered what that word was right behind Wang Chuqin. You are something heart. Lion heart, maybe?
Five, two.
The Wang Chuqin fan club had been in touch with me recently, so get a little bit of inside info.
There was a backhand there from Lin Wenru at one point. But it's the Chinese pair that get the point.
Yeah, this is a spectacular point. That's the backhand you were talking about. And Wang Chuqin ready to bring it right back. Again, rackets are going to be high in every hand here. Well, one hand per person typically. No Ugo on court right now.
Nice little flick there. Nicely done by Wang. And a big shot as well.
That was just so smooth. This is some serious swag in over the table. Oh man, guides it the complete opposite direction while he's floating in for the forehand flick.
He's been a busy guy today, Wang Chuqin. His third match of the day.
Whoa.
What's going on there? Come on.
Someone's being attacked. Where was security? How did that bear, was it a beaver or a bear? Oh, a lion, like Lionheart, like Wang Chuqin. I'm sorry, Wang Chuqin.
A beaver or a bear?
You know what? I don't spend a lot of time in the wild. Anyway, open rally here, moving forward. Wang Chuqin able to cover a ball from out of position.
That's a great shot. They really pick some points up here.
So maybe you could understand the confusion about the lion.
I will say. Just clipping the net. Look at all those game points. They have wrapped up this game in double quick time. Wang and Sun.
Wang and Sun of China.
They make that look so easy, didn't they?
One love.
So what do they need to do, Zheng and Lin, to try and arrest this, the progression of points, the way they're attacking them? What can they do?
Well, I think, again, they're going to have to be a bit surprising. They're going to have to try to get the opponents off balance, change up their depths, catch the players just a little bit behind or put pressure deep on the table. Easier said than done because they move very well in and out. So they leave few holes in the game, sometimes maybe less rotation on the serve to get a popped up receive here and there, follow the serve quickly with an attack, well placed. I mean, a lot of tall orders against players who aren't making many mistakes at all. Well, this here is a good emptier serve, right?
Yeah, I was just gonna say,
Less rotation on it, so it's overlifted by Wang Chuqin. Curse of the commentator, COC.
That's two.
That was if Cardi B were commentating. Two serving to three. Wang Chuqin signaling what he's going to do out here.
That's more like it. Big roar from the crowd.
All.
Clever play. Xia Xia taking the feet out of Zheng Yijing in this. Tough to tell where she's going to go. Long push. That's all that's needed with good placement. And of course, the beware of dog sign, that attack that's waiting behind that ball. Good play to the short side here. Lin Yunru shortening it up, hitting it right into the body of Xia Xia.
All level now.
Mixed doubles is very interesting to see because the order switches all the time, but it's the only time we see the men and the women professionally playing against each other.
Yep. Went after that serve.
5-4.
And they're just very different games in general. The women tend to stay closer and play more of a speed game. So compact strokes, the timing is different. That can be tough for the men to adjust to. But the amount of spin and pace on the ball, the power on the ball, could be a little bit different for the women to adjust to. Good down the line shot here on the step around as Wang Chuqin turns the corner and doesn't look back. A few big points here after a tied up 4-4. Remember, best of five. This is a crucial game for the pair in blue.
Five, six.
I wonder if that's a sign of tension. It's a good point, again, for Zheng Yijing and Lin Wenru. But the catch, I mean, she would normally catch that ball. I wonder if that's nerves.
Oh, lovely backhand there. Great power from Wang.
7-6.
Yeah, and the placement's just right to cause trouble. Lin Minru's able to get a racket on this encounter, but he had to come from backhand and turn to play the forehand side of the racket. Just amazing, the precision. This gets really interesting for me right about now because this could be the big pivot point. The world champions could break it open, take a 2-0 lead. Or these two on screen from the beautiful island could turn things around, get some momentum, and tie it up at one game apiece. But it's clutch time, the business end of game number two.
They've just gone ahead.
8-7.
Important juncture.
Zheng Yijing with a very solid opening loop there, changing the timing up for Wang Chuqin. While the shot doesn't come down, if you're Zheng Jiaqi, if you're the coach for these two, you're in the corner, you're saying, okay, good. You took the right shot. You earned the opportunity. To let that opportunity slip, well, would have been the mistake, but there was nothing wrong about the decision there. 8 points apiece now.
Oh, went after it.
9-8.
Didn't work out for Zheng.
Demo.
So 1 point between them now. Timeout taken, and the serve was Sun Ying Xia.
One-point save.
9-10.
Timeout or no? I guess that, here it is. Sun Ying Xia.
Went for the banana flip.
Well, this is a nice adjustment. Heavier spin on the serve. After one before had been floated long, meaning Wang Chuqin overlifted. This time it was heavier spin that clipped the net and out. Service variation strong, alternating serves until one pair has a 2-point lead to take the game.
Another match point, the third one now. Game point, excuse me. Getting ahead of myself.
Yi Jing trying to stay loose out there.
They have done it here, Wang and Sun. They've taken the second game. A much, much tighter one. It's a big ask now, isn't it, for Zhang and Lin?
Yeah, the odds are even more in the favor of the two on screen, the world champions, Xia Xia and Lionheart. I don't know if you ever think funny thoughts to make you laugh when you're by yourself, but apologizing for something over and over and then continuing to do it, obviously that's not intentional, but it just becomes funny at a certain point. And we're not at that point yet. I mean, if someone won 11 points in a row off the net and kept saying sorry. Very genuinely.
What a time to be doing that, but they have got a 3-point cushion and a 2-game one as well.
A little bit of giving back, a little philanthropy here after the first 2 points.
Really good placement from Sun Yuxia. What a response that was.
Players, the upper hand here, come back quite determined to not let it be so close. Edge for edge! Edge for edge! The touch, the feeling here. He recovered an edge ball with an edge.
That's rare.
I mean, ridiculously rare.
Brilliant point from Wang. What was the umpire saying there?
Oh, interesting. So we warned him. He said you contacted the ball inside the table, I believe. It's possible he said you tossed it from inside the table because he does tend to throw the ball back, which would seem more reasonable. But either way, neither of those is allowed. So for some reason, I thought he said fault. He does not have to give a warning, but he did. There was no point awarded.
They are running away with this third game, Wang and Sun.
8-1
up. Oh, what a shot!
This was an Adriana Diaz no-look shot. He turns his back to the table to continue the momentum. Take another look at this. He'll have to do that later. Look at him run away. I love it.
Oh, the fans will have loved that.
I want to see a replay of his run again. Still 7 points up as Wang Chuqin signals the serve that he wants to get the third ball of choice.
That's a good response to that serve. Good return from Lin.
TJ, didn't you get my request?
Beautiful placement again, right to that far corner. And that sets up match points.
7 match points to become the first ever Grand Smash, specifically Singapore Smash champions.
One saved. Still 6 championship points.
Good scoop from under the table there, Lin Yunru.
And they've done it.
11-4.
Wang Jujin and Sung Yingsha are your first ever mixed double champions at the Singapore Smash.